do a la 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 a la like this. Gotta be something for me to write this.
Coin Flip, the weekly poetry showcase presented by Mackin Productions with the Malolo book series as part of RM Definitive at Accents Bookstore. And today we're featuring the poet Josephine Casey with the book Life's Poetry. Hello, Josephine.
Hi. Hi, everyone. My name is Josephine. I'm the author of Life's Poetry. And my book, I'll tell you a little bit about my book. It's a collection of inspirational poems that I've written. It's a balance of everything in life, right? In life, we go through ups and downs, the journeys, trials, tribulations. So it's a bit of a mixture about everything. Some days we wake up, we're energized, we're pumped, we're happy, you know, like we feel enthusiastic. And then everyone has their down days, right? Like some of us are depressed and we feel lonely and, you know, we're exhausted and we just feel down. So that's what it is. There's a poem about like your mood, what you're going through life, the struggles, journeys, there's love poems in there. And it's just a collection of poems that everyone can relate to. It's realistic.
So I guess basically that's what inspired you to write the whole book. What was your creative process when you're putting everything together? Because you talked about touching on different things in life.
Mm-hmm.
Did you find that was hard to bring all of that together in one book?
I would say no. I mean, it was challenging, but I wouldn't say hard. I would say it was challenging because you're being real, right? You're
okay.
Pouring out your emotions, your feelings, and you're actually like writing it down on paper.
Right.
You're telling people like kind of like what you're going through, your journey. And as well, like this book is also, it's most of it is my journey as well as like, you know, when friends come to talk to you, when
right.
they're venting, and then like family members, when you're, okay. when people are going through, you know, struggles, you kind of see things from their point of view, their perspective. So then I kind of like write poetry based on that as well. So just
okay.
mine and, you know, like friends, family, and just everyone, just in general. So,
mm-hmm.
I mean, the challenging part was just, I guess actually just putting it down and knowing that, okay, well, people are going to ask you questions about this poem,
right.
but you know what? It's real. It's realistic. Everyone can relate to it. I'm pretty sure not everyone's had a happy day. Not everyone's had like been depressed, right? So it's something that everyone can relate to.
Mm-hmm. So you talked about your journey. When you originally started out, did you intend to be just a poetry writer or you had planned to be something else? Like, was poetry your first reason for becoming an author?
I would say yes. I mean, I've always liked writing poetry. I've been writing poetry about 10, 15 years. You know, like I always kind of like writing, you know, when you're in school, that sort of stuff, when they have classes, I would, you know, just start writing down stuff, writing out
okay.
my feelings, my emotions. So I would say, yeah, I mean, poetry kind of like connected me to being an author and, you know, who knows?
Right. So you then basically feel it's become a part of you.
Yes.
Which is right.
Yes.
Okay. So with your book being Life's Poetry, as you said, touch about life's experiences and everything, which of these poems is your favorite poem?
I would say the first one. The first one, Life's Poetry, title, that's the signature poem. I mean,
okay.
that I would say explains, pretty much kind of like wraps up everything in the book.
Okay.
I can recite it if you
sure,
like,
if you
I can read it.
Definitely, please.
I mean, that I would say is my favorite.
Okay.
Okay, and it's called Life's Poetry. Some days are good, some days are bad. Some days it's just enough you've had. Life's a mystery, painting its history, waiting to unfold a story to be told. A way of living with elevated expressions of thought. That's life's poetry sought. Life is what you see and make it to be, the slightest opinions we think and feel. It can be overwhelming, confusing, and losing, but it can be pleasing and uplifting, always shifting. Life's a poetry in its own form, with ups and downs, winds and storms. It's how you overcome and supersede these times that will truly be the test for you to shine. See life's poetry as an art you frame, every day something new or maybe the same. It's a view, a take on life too. Depends on what you intend to do. So, strive for you. Hurt, pain, power, fame, it's all a part of the human heart. The challenges and journeys through life help form and compose who you are. Different experiences, different appearances. Some have it easy, some not. Some caught, some fought. It can also be how you process your thought. That, again, is life's poetry thought. So that pretty much sums up everything. I mean, life, as I just mentioned, has its ups and downs, winds and storms, right? And I mean, throughout life, it's how you feel about life and how you see it. That's how you can overcome like those trials or tribulations, because it's all a thinking process as well, right? Every situation that you are, you can turn a negative into a positive. You can always find something positive about it, even if it's the littlest thing.
So it'd be safe to say then life's poetry basically is like your outtake, your philosophy of life, right? Like how you approach it?
Yeah, okay. I would say that.
Okay. Now I know you have a daughter.
Yes.
Okay. How old is your daughter?
She's 8.
Okay. When you were writing your book, Life's Poetry, did she figure into this at all?
Yes, of course. Okay, of course she did. Of course she did.
And did she inspire any specific poem?
Yeah, she did. There's a poem, actually it's her favorite poem. It's called Smile.
Okay.
That's on page 27 of my book. She really likes, do you want me to, I can read it. She reads it actually better than me because it's one of her favorite poems.
Well, too bad we don't have it here. You'll have to bring it next time.
Definitely. Yes. Smile. A smile is what brings the best out of you. It's something everyone should often do. A smile lights up your day each time you have something to say. A smile is what you should always have on your face to show the happiness, the love, and the peace. The happiness you sing and the peace you share to everyone that cares. Smile and show the joy and happiness it brings. Just smile. She inspired me because she's always smiling.
Well, kids are the joy of life, so yes. That's a good thing.
Yes.
So what is next for life's poetry?
What's next for life's poetry?
Yes.
I mean, I've actually done a lot of things with life poetry. I've done a couple of book signings with Chapters, Indigo, and I'm going to continue that this year, 2014. I'm also part of a team, GTA, Great Toronto Authors. We're going on tour with our books, so that's something very exciting.
Yeah.
And I've been doing stuff with the Brampton Library as well, like going in and pretty much like presenting my book. And I've also, my book's also available at the Mississauga Branch Library. So I'm just out there pretty much.
Pretty good. So it sounds like you have a lot of things going on.
Yes.
About the group project, like what would be your, I guess, message to other people coming up, or what do you want to communicate as a new writer to other people?
I guess I would say, I mean, if this is your passion and this is your dream, I would say just go for it. The hardest thing is to actually just go for it and just do it. I mean, I've had a lot of challenges myself, and I've had a lot of people when they've come up to me like, oh my God, you published a book. And I'm like, yeah, I did. And like, oh, I've always wanted to write a book.
Okay.
So I would say, okay, do it. Why not?
Okay.
And it's just that process. It's just actually like getting in the mind frame, setting that deadline, saying, I'm going to do it. And just actually pushing yourself to overcome those barriers and actually do it.
Okay.
So I would say if it's your passion, if it's your dream, just go for it. All the best. I mean, make your dream come true.
True. Well, you seem very focused and very driven in putting your artwork out there with Life's Poetry.
Thank you.
You spoke about a group, so is part of that why you got together with a group, or?
Yeah, I mean, like I'm a very outgoing person. I like to, you know, encourage and inspire people, and that's another thing about my book. Like, I feel that a lot of people have mentioned that, oh my God, you know, I feel so inspired and that sort of stuff. So a part of me being a part of this group too is just connecting with other authors.
Okay.
We're taking it to another level, and we're just showing, you know, others and other authors that you can do it too. You know, we're out promoting our books, and it promotes literature, which is pretty big.
Right. So where can we see Life's Poetry or you with this group next?
Well, the group's going to be at Knowledge Bookstore on next week, Saturday, actually. So that's January 25th.
Okay.
That's our second tour date. So we're going to be there at Knowledge Bookstore. Doors open at 4 o'clock. The show starts at 5. It's going to be a wonderful show. Life's Poetry, my book, is available at Accents Bookstore here.
Yes.
Knowledge Bookstore in Brampton. It's also available on Amazon. Chapters Indigo for the ebook, as well as Kobo Books, and available at the Mississauga Library, and that's pretty much it.
Okay. So just one more question, because you talked about what your daughter inspired you to write, what life inspired you to write. Which one of these poems, if you had to label yourself as one of them, which one would be most speak to you as Josephine Casey, the writer?
It kind of all relates to me a bit.
Okay.
I would have to say, you know what, I'm going to stick with the first one.
The first one?
Yeah, I mean, life's poetry, because it's a mixture of everything that I'm going through. I mean,
okay.
The ups and downs. And
right.
I would have to say that one speaks to me more. That's one of my favorites. I do have a lot of favorites in here. Motivation is another favorite one that I've performed a couple of times. And yeah, I would say life's poetry.
Okay.
The first one.
So there's one poem that jumps out at me, because obviously you're a businesswoman, a strong author.
Thank you.
I see you wrote a poem called Not Just a Pretty Face.
Yes.
What inspired you to do that?
Okay. Well, what inspired me to write that poem is, I guess, just going through like a past relationship of mine.
Okay.
That I've been through. And, you know, being a female, I've gotten like, oh my god, you're beautiful, and
yes.
and that type of stuff.
Okay.
And just in that particular relationship, I mean, there was nothing else offered besides the looks. Like,
yes.
I was just being complimented on my looks. So for me, I'm more than just a pretty face. I mean, like, I have so much going on inside, you know, and it's, for me, I look at the inside. It's not necessarily all about the appearance and
right.
how the person looks. So that poem is kind of, like, that inspired me to write that poem, I would say.
Well, definitely that resonates with a lot of things that relations-wise people are dealing with.
Right.
And also, I think it kind of speaks to you as an author, right? You want to have your artwork being entertaining,
right.
but you still want substance to it.
Right,
okay.
exactly.
All right, so do you mind if you hear that one?
Oh, no, definitely.
Okay.
Okay, so not just a pretty face.
This is it.
18? Okay. Not just a pretty face. A pretty face, is that all you see? Over there, looking at me. I have feelings, I have meanings. I'm not just a pretty face. Look on the inside instead of the outside. I am true and real as I can ever be. See me for who I am. Try to understand. I'm not just a pretty face. Don't just sit there and miscalculate. Don't just sit there and underestimate. I have a set mind, a set state. I'm not just a pretty face. Can you relate? I am ambitious, not fake, not fictitious. Have faith. I'm not just a pretty face.
That is pretty impressive.
Thank
right
you.
Okay. I am definitely going to take the time to read through the whole book.
Thank you.
Definitely.
Hope you're inspired.
Definitely will be. Okay. So we'll then obviously look forward to that poetry. Is there any questions from the audience?
I have a question.
Yes.
You said your daughter inspired you. Do you have any other poets that inspired you?
Maya Angelou. She's one of my favorite poets. There's this one particular one that always speaks to me. It's called Phenomenal Woman. And yeah, I mean, just going out there, you know, like just having a full-time job, doing life's poetry, and, you know, like being a full-time parent, I mean, that inspires me. So being a phenomenal woman, and that one speaks to me, and she's one of my favorite poets.
Good.
Are there any other questions from the audience? Okay. Well, Josephine, just wanted to thank you for taking your time to come to CoinFlip and share some
thank
of your work.
You.
We wish you all the best with Life's Poetry and the groups that you're working with, and hope to see you again soon.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
All right.